On November 1st, 2023, at 10:54 a.m. local time, the fastest-growing volcano on the planet, which is also Kamchatka's tallest point, produced an unusually powerful eruption that followed several days of intensifying eruptive activity. Occurring at the Klyuchevskoy Volcano in Russia, it represented this volcano's largest eruption in 29 years, as a 1994 eruption it produced was slightly larger. As a section of Klyuchevskoy's summit crater and overlying cone exploded, a sustained plume of ash was ejected to a height of 46,000 feet or approximately 14 kilometers, causing a fairly thick layer of ash to fall around this volcano's more than 4,755-meter or 15,600-foot high summit. Yet, only several seconds after this eruption began, it appears that a landslide of sorts was generated, resulting in built-up pressure from Klyuchevskoy's summit being rapidly released, which resulted in the creation of a highly energetic and long-reaching pyroclastic flow. Racing down the ice and snow-covered slopes at a speed of 150 miles per hour or 241.4 kilometers per hour, it took only 2 minutes to reach a location 8 kilometers away, just northeast of the extinct volcano known as Seredny. This pyroclastic flow may have subsequently continued onwards for as much as another 8.1 kilometers, which at this distance largely stayed within a river channel going towards the north. Later, pyroclastic flows also raced to the southeast, traveling what I estimated to be a distance of between 6 and 10.3 kilometers. While these pyroclastic flows were at their furthest extent still 17 kilometers away from a populated place, their generation caused another problem. As, due to its height, Klyuchevskoy is partially covered in thick glaciers. Thus, when these unusually large pyroclastic flows were generated, they quickly melted large volumes of ice and snow, which created a series of Lahars. These Lahars deposited layers of mud that appear to be more than 20 centimeters thick along riverbeds as far away as 57.5 kilometers away from Klyuchevskoy's summit, which blocked at least two sections of local roads with one spot east of Klyuchi and perhaps as much as three spots south of Kozyrevsk. After the peak of this paroxysm ended, a sustained eruption column continued to be generated, albeit at a decreased height of 36,000 feet for the next 14 hours. This plume then further decreased to 33,000 feet in height, but drifted more than 1,400 miles to the east and then southeast, meaning isolated particles of ash could have fallen in the far western Aleutians, including at Attu's station. As a whole, Klyuchevskoy's recent eruption sequence could best have been described as a strong vulcanian eruption, with pyroclastic flows reaching unusually long runout distances largely due to the massive size and height of this stratovolcano. Although there are no firm estimates yet for the size of the eruption which just occurred, I personally estimate that around 12 million cubic meters of ash and tephra was released, meaning the eruption would likely rate on the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index as a 3. While more similarly powerful explosions could technically occur in the next few days, in my opinion, I expect that only far smaller explosive activity will occur simply due to the cause of this eruption which just occurred. As, during the entire month of October, high-intensity lava output of a primarily Strombolian manner created a brand new 110-meter-wide and 33-meter-tall small cinder cone that completely covered the summit crater, causing Klyuchevskoy to temporarily reach a new record height. The center of the small cinder cone then completely plugged the main vent below it, which caused an increasing amount of gas and pressure to build. This pressure got stronger and stronger until it finally fractured the overlying rock, likely causing the destruction of the overlying small cinder cone, causing a very small landslide, which then released long-traveling pyroclastic flows. However, in my opinion, I would still not go any closer than 15 kilometers away from Klyuchevskoy's summit, as strong eruptive activity is still theoretically possible. This entire eruptive sequence was strong enough that it caused school closures in both Klyuchi and Ust-Kamchatsk, at least for a day on November 1st. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.